We're back in Killian with Stacey Duvic, who's a local girl, grew up in Ponchatoula, lives now in Springfield. We're at Killian Town Hall, where there's always a lot going on, and you're with Louisiana Economic Development. Everybody wants to know a lot about that. But first, how about the economic development in our own backyard right here in Killian? What do you think?
Oh my gosh, things are growing and changing so fast in our and across the state, but particularly here in the South, Livingston, Tangipahoa, St. Tammany, all across the North Shore, we're seeing just exponential, growth and change coming. So,
well, the mayor Kenny Bahi really has put an emphasis on tourism, and you can see it paying off because every weekend, Killian, I mean, it's a real center of activity around the river.
It really is. He did put an emphasis on tourism, which is what the community wanted. When we started the Louisiana Development Ready Communities process with the council and the mayor, we surveyed the community to see what they wanted. And tourism type industry is what they were looking for. That's not necessarily what Louisiana Economic Development works with, but we also work with our tourism folks on a daily basis because that is a huge industry here across the state. Some parishes, it's the only industry.
Well, pulling the lens out a little bit, you look at the popularity of swamp people and the Louisiana swamp culture craze that's nationwide. You just have to be optimistic that we can capitalize on it because we're the real deal. Most of the cast of Swamp People live within 20 miles of where we're sitting right now.
Oh, sure, absolutely. The river, the food, all of the culture stuff, that tourism piece is so, so important.
And who knows if we could do Silicon Valley, but the one thing we know is that we can create restaurants, seemingly an endless number, with great food that you wouldn't get anywhere else. Tourism, hospitality, fun, festivals, these are things we know we can accomplish.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, look at the festivals across the state. There's not one weekend that you can't pick a town and you can go to some sort of festival, crawfish festivals and gumbo festivals and strawberry festivals. I mean, there's something every weekend here with the festivals and fairs.
I don't know about the whole state, but around here, one thing that LED has been telling communities between, say, Denham and Slidell, is to prepare for growth, get a plan, because whether you like it or not, growth is coming. And look, growth ought to be a good thing. Just go someplace that is not growing and you'll see why it is.
Oh, absolutely. People panic whenever they see a plan sometimes and they think that a plan means that giant industry is coming to their town. That's not necessarily the case. What actually happens is growth is going to come and change is going to come. People want to be here. So you can either prepare for that growth or it's just going to happen. And if you just let it happen, it's not always the most positive thing. So if you're prepared for that and you have ordinances in place for what you want, it just makes that growth a little easier to control. You're a little more prepared when it comes to infrastructure and water and sewer and roads and traffic and all those things. Otherwise, it's just it's going to happen one way or the other, so it's best to prepare for it.
Well, the naysayers might bring up, look, roads take money, infrastructure, that takes money, and of course we want to grow logically, but LED can just give you a plan. They can't give you the bucks usually, right?
Right. Well, what we do is we come in and facilitate with the community. It's their plan. It's not our plan. We want to come in and you tell us what you want. We're not going to come in and tell you what's best for your community. From what you want, we try to find resources, whether they're LED resources or whether they're tourism resources or Division of Administration resources. It could be federal or private resources. We have somebody on our staff now that takes those plans and is searching constantly for resources to help the community. We don't want to just give them a plan, go back to Baton Rouge, and leave everybody stuck.
Well, pulling the lens back even farther, what about growth in general here in Louisiana? I mean, it's a crazy time after the pandemic, and there are all kinds of weird things in the economy. What do you think?
Well, we've been looking on the state level at different things that we didn't look at 3 years ago. Remote workers have become a huge piece of the decision-making factors now. Broadband, we're seeing every day, you see news about broadband and gumbo funds and all of the things that it takes for remote workers. So now, to me, the rural areas have the opportunity to have folks that are living in their community, they're working in their community, but they're working maybe from their homes.
That's a good example because, look, maybe in Silicon Valley, a lot of those people, not a majority, but a great share, would like to live in the country for the obvious reasons of our lifestyle. But if so, how can you help to set up the internet infrastructure that would be necessary for a rural area to cash in.
Well, the governor's office now has the governor's office of broadband. Beneath is there running that program, and there's dollars coming in every day. They made an announcement from, I think, Lake Providence a couple weeks ago, the governor did, on broadband and who has applied for those funds and who's gotten those funds. And that's just kind of the first tranche of those funds. So a lot of it's working with your providers to get that broadband out there. Without that broadband, that remote working is not going to happen.
So the million-dollar question, and maybe it's the trillion-dollar question, is are we or are we not headed into a recession? And of course, crazy Louisiana, we're always counter-cyclical to the national economy anyway. But looking forward, is LED optimistic about the state's economy for the next few years? I mean, oil is sky high. That should be good, right?
Yeah, I mean, they had Commerce and Industry Board yesterday, and I think there were 14 or 15 projects in the billions of dollars approved yesterday at Commerce and Industry. I think the outlook is really good. LED is working projects every day when we have our staff meetings. Everybody's like, oh, you know, we're busy and moving forward with projects. Project managers are never in the office, and our retention folks are working projects every day. So it's not even new industry coming in. It's the growth of the industry that exists.
So let's get back to the Killian level. You're holding a copy of Killian's three-year plan, and you wouldn't think a little town like Killian would have a three-year plan, but they do, and you say the state helped them draft it, which means that just about any community around here could do one.
Oh, absolutely. We have 303 municipalities and 64 parishes, and everybody's eligible for that program. We've worked with about 52 communities, some on the parish level, mostly on the municipal level, where we have folks that want to move forward and kind of get control over the growth and the change that's coming, or increase the growth. We have communities, Oak Grove is one of our communities up in East Carroll Parish. I think there's 1,200 people in town. So there's no community too small for us to come in and work with. We come in and facilitate. We come in and survey your communities and make sure that we're putting in your plan and you're putting in your plan what the community is looking for.
So if a town or even a village wanted to go in a particular direction, could you help them to access resources? Maybe they wouldn't know that there's a governor's office of broadband where they can start the process of getting high-speed internet.
Yep, that's exactly what we do. So we come in and facilitate, and those goals are set. And then we have somebody on our staff now that is, like I said, going through those plans and trying to find resources for those things, connecting them with the right people. And there's a lot of copy and paste. If something's working in Abbeville, Louisiana, it might work in Killian. You never know. So if you know, we can take some of those things that are best practices in other communities and bring them, why reinvent the wheel?
What else do you want to share with us?
You know, things are busy and growing, and business has not slowed down. I think we're past the pandemic piece. We're working with communities every day, so it's good to be back out and about and working with our partners and on the state and local level.
Injuries can occur anytime, any place, and it may not be your fault. I'm attorney Sherman Madden, and it's my duty to make sure you get the legal representation that you deserve. At the Mack Law Firm, we represent you and your family, and we'll make sure your legal needs are met. Contact us at tangylawteam.com. Our team is ready to help.